Okay, I think I have everything set up. How's everyone doing? Hey, Pom-pom-pom-pom. Yeah, we should have everything set. I don't know why the donation bar is stuck there. I was giving it a test and it just got stuck. Whatever. I'll let it roll. Let me know how audio volumes are right now. I have music set deliberately low. Things all right. Okay, cool. And obviously, I haven't tested the Elgato audio yet. I've been messing with it. We'll give it a shot in just a moment. I'm just making sure everything else is set, which it should be, honestly. Also, just giving some people just a couple more minutes to come in. Actually, you know what? Yeah, let's go ahead and get it popped up. Let me tweak desktop audio. We can mute now. Oh, and I'll also resync the capture card. Okay, good. Synced up now. I haven't played Ape Escape 1 in a good while, which is why I'm not 100% sure if this is going to end up like it's definitely not gonna be single si sitting, but I'm not sure if it's gonna be like two sitting or what. We'll have to roll with it. Also, I don't know why chat's not showing user colors. It should be coming up. Let me see. I got an idea. Let me. Let's remove it and try to re-add. Oh, thank you, Starstruck. Thank you. I'm starting soon. Hold on. I'm just needing to kind of what's about with stream elements because it's being difficult. Okay, let's try to add it now. There we go. Okay, we're back up and running. Let me just give a quick test in chat. Bingo. All right. Cool. I think we're ready to go now. Let me just click save. Bingo. Oh, also, yeah, donation bar, I mostly said it there just as like a random test. But I will basically like but that actual donation go is real. It's going to be when I say 7th Gen Jank stream, I'm going to make a more formal announcement after the stream like on Twitter maybe. But I want to stream 3 7th Gen games, just random poll. I didn't even have a rhyme or reason. That's going to be Dark Void, the Splatterhouse reboot, and Never Dead. Don't and probably try to do each game in one sitting over a 3-day stretch. Don't know exactly when we'll do this, but hey, I figured just kind of get things on a start. Yeah, I'll post about it again after the stream. I'll make a tweet and kind of see what reaction's like. There we go. All right. You do not resync because OBS loves to just drop audio and video sync. There we go. Okay. Look at him. Look at the little fella. He doesn't know. Oh, also, I mean, it's been a while since we've done the stream. Last time was finishing up Ghost Trick. But since then, we've added two emotes, which will be these two right here. I'll add more later on. I just need to like commission them. We're gonna let the intro play. I'll see. Okay, I can already tell it's a little bit loud. Let me just drop it a little bit. And just let me know how game volume is now versus my voice. Louder? Okay, let me drop it. We'll try it with that. How about now? Oh, hold on. There we go. At least turn on the scan lines. Yeah, Ape Escape's art style is definitely unique. Like, I mean, you could compared to some other PS1 games, but it did kind of have its own niche. And yeah, I love it. Also, hello, Sidestar Rock. Again, thank you for the sub. Okay, let's get started here. Also, this will be the U.S. version, by the way. This is not the PAL British English dub. I don't really have a preference, because I don't really remember how the British English voices sounded.
Hey, Spike, did the professor finish the time station yet? Are we gonna get to go back in time?
He said he'd be finished with it today. Let's go.
I can't wait to check out the dinosaurs. And what about the future?
Yeah, we'll keep talking, because I'm going first.
That's right there. Hey, wait up. You better hurry up.
I know, Ape Escape 2's dub specifically has a lot of 4Kids alumni, like around that era.
Spike, Jake, over here, watch out!
Spike, the time station!
No, run you two! It works. It actually works. We did it, Natalie.
There we go.
We did it. The time station is complete.
We don't have time for celebrating. We've got to do something.
Yeah, definitely of its time. And I don't mean that as a detriment.
Listen carefully. Something awful has happened. There's been an accident. The time station has been activated by Spectre, and you're being transported back in time. You'll soon arrive in the Lost Land when dinosaurs roam the Earth. Spectre has sent the apes back in time to try to change the course of history. His plans for world domination have begun. And if we don't stop the apes, history will be changed forever. You're our only chance. Two of my gadget inventions, the Stun Club and the Time Net, were also caught in the transport. I want you to use them to catch the apes and send them back here. The Stun Club can be used to defend yourself against attackers. And when you use it on the apes, they'll be stunned. And you'll have an extra second to catch them with the Time Net. There isn't time for any monkey business, Spike. Our fate is in your hands. We're depending on you. Be careful.
Also, yeah, I fucking love this game's soundtrack. Like, it's, I mean, overall, like, I think this is the most balanced game of the main trilogy. There are parts of 3 I like more than this, but I think as a complete package, this is still the best one. 2 I still really like. And yep, immediately, I forgot, jumping with R1. Oh no, we gotta do this right, we gotta go stealth. Also, yeah, get ready for a lot of trophies. Because I think this game has one of the more brain-dead trophy systems. I could be wrong, though. You can't see me. See?
Yes.
Also, yeah, I will be streaming 2 and 3 after this, because I actually I got a new upscaler that works much better in the OBS, especially when it comes to deinterlacing.
Great.
Also, I'm not sure. I can't remember if this game requires 100% or not, but either way, I might not do it. We'll see. We'll play a lot of this by ear to see how it goes. Also, yeah, favorite track in the game is the hub here. The monkey data. Oops. I'm so used to pressing circle to cancel out. Okay, what's this room? Big game court? Oh yeah! Got Spectre coins hidden in the stages. Once you collect the number of Spectre coins in the monitor, you can play that minigame. Right. Touchpad for... Okay, we don't have any of them yet. I keep pressing the options button. That's the only thing I don't like about playing this on the PS5, is that start and selector on the touchpad, because the button where select would be, it's the share button. So it's, yeah. Primordial ooze.
Look what I've got, a new gadget. Check it out.
This is the water net. Use it when you're underwater. I equipped it with an oxygen meter. I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training room. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you to continue on to the next area. Well, good luck and be careful.
The underwater net. Use underwater. I actually forget how this works. Swim around using left stick, exit the water by jumping near the surface, and jump. Speed up, use jump button. When it's swimming or resurfacing, the faster you swim, the faster you'll win. Okay. Sure. Okay, yeah, the right stick doesn't... Actually, hold on, isn't it? Yeah, the right stick just shoots nets when you click it. Also, yeah, somehow didn't mention this is one of the first game. I can't remember if it was the first or... No, I'm sorry, it was the first game to require the DualShock. Which, I mean, that was a big deal, but at least a big deal back in the day. I wouldn't know entirely because I was, like, a year old. There's a monkey in the pool. On it. I'm a master. Also, I just realized something. Hold on, let me let the... Yeah, that meter refill is reused in, I think Tokyo Jungle. Which I had to assume would have at least some of the same staff. Because it was a first party Sony game. Alright, we can go. Get wet. I don't think you can say that in Twitch.
I'm going for it.
He's going for it. You die by pushing. Oh yeah, we went over this. We can do it. Yeah. Shit, he's caught on. Hi-ya. Hi-ya. I got it. Hi-ya. Never mind. Using movable camera, you can look on your surroundings with the left stick. Press the L2 button again, return to normal. And so the back camera, pressing L1 to move behind you. Oh yeah, so it's center. That was part of my plan all along. Honestly, I'm wondering how the camera is going to be in this game, because again, it's been a while. I remember it being actually pretty manageable, but it's also, again, it's been long enough. And plus, I'm more accustomed to 3, at least in terms of how it looks and feels. What was that noise? Oh. I did not expect that to reach. I'll take it. There we go, there's one of the Spectre coins. Let me get the Azejo.
This bites.
Ah, damn it. I thought it would start knocking out your health points, but nope, you just instantly die. Does it reset? Okay, at least keeps my my monkey progress. The count of escaped apes. Skedaddled simians. Oh, let's see, hold on, did it keep... Oh, I'm gonna do that a lot. Oh yeah, it did keep the Spectre coin. I can't remember how to get up there. Oh, wait. Oh, there we go.
Yes.
Also, yeah, I was gonna say that reminded me of Nessie from Mario 64. At least, was it Nessie or... Shit. No, Dory. Okay. I think some people still call her Nessie. But yeah, I know who you mean. I can't remember what this area was for. Hold on, let's whack the mailbox. Oh, training space. Okay. Okay, yeah, was it? Plus it was the 3D World one. I haven't played 3D World in a while. I never bought that Switch port. How was it? surrounded by a steep cliff, if you fall off, you're finished. Be careful on the edge of a cliff. Use a D-pad or L2 to move the camera around. Oh yeah, D-pad is a camera button. You got it. Let's cut around energy fuel. That's also you're getting 100 of these. Okay. We'll last longer. Door is blocked in white. How does it open? You'll need to find a red switch to open that gate. No, he did not give us that gadget yet. I will have to go back then. Alright, you can't use it while moving. Oh yeah, I forgot the camera is inverted. What if I can change that? I mean, if not, I can adapt, it's no big deal. Weird. Okay, no, he can't. Actually, that's not so weird. No, we want to exit. Oh my god, how did I miss? There we go. I've redeemed myself. Ow. May as well get the other three chips. Come on. There we go. There you go, the midair catch. Look, it looked like a laser eye right there. The T-Rex is very aggressive and won't be hurt by your weapons. Hit T-Rex and run to the rocks. When T-Rex runs to you, jump up and out of the way. It's hard enough that you may just drop that monkey. Oh. Oh my god. I was so worried it would take long enough for him to recover.
Yes.
Oh yeah, side note. If anyone knows of overlay artists, let me know, because I actually would kind of want to get 4x3 and 16x9 overlays, just so I don't have the screen just sitting here. Give it a little pizzazz. I would just make myself, but I have no clue what I would want to do for the design of it, so...
Look what I've got! A new gadget! Check it out!
Here's a monkey radar. It'll help you track those monkeys down. I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training room. Without training, it will be too dangerous for you.
Yeah.
I'm going for it!
I at least remember how this works. Just... We just gotta point it. Okay. I forgot the camera system where they show you what... later games would have a button you press it to show you the preview where the monkey is. That's not in this game. There we go. Oh, we have to wait until we get to the... Oh boy. We have to wait until we get to this stage.
Spike, you're now on your way to the mysterious time of the jungle ruins. You must navigate through thick jungles filled with beasts never seen before.
Go on. Never seen before.
Ruins, but be very careful. The temple is laden with...
What do you mean by that, Doc?
...ways and dark dungeons. Oh, yes. And you...
Are you gonna experience some cryptids?
The apes have varying fields of vision, so in most cases you can sneak up on them by crawling around rather than running after them. You won't be noticed as quickly if you remain low to the
hitting
ground.
Hitting that yonky splunky as he's talking.
You'll discover many great things on your journey, but try to stay focused. You must locate all of the apes. Every second that passes gives Spectre a chance to succeed. We're counting on you.
Hello, Professor. Remember me? It's me, Spectre, the future leader of the new age. That's
the
right.
New age.
Apes will soon rule the world, just as it should have been from the beginning.
Spectre, what's going on here? What are you planning to do?
I forgot that genuinely flabbergasted delivery.
He's at the amusement park.
What? He's that cute little monkey that everyone loves to come and see? But how?
Yes, that's right. I stumbled onto this incredible invention of yours, this peak point helmet, and it's given me remarkable knowledge and great powers. And now, I plan to rule the world, and I owe it to you, Professor.
Spectre, you must listen to me carefully. It's true that the peak point helmet will augment your intelligence to heightened levels when it's worn. However, it is still incomplete. It's never been tested and may be very dangerous to use. I insist that you bring the Peak Point helmet back to me immediately.
Bring it back? Are you kidding? I'm sorry, Professor, but it's too late. I've already made duplicate helmets for my new army of apes. There's no stopping us now. The future is mine!
Well, I wouldn't really call it duplicates if they have, like, giant-ass siren lights.
I'm smarter than you. I even figured out how to use the time station. I've already sent my armies back in time to rewrite history. No longer will humans be the dominant species. I will rule this world. Don't bother trying to stop me.
Huh. Spike will find you. Just wait. You'll see. We're not gonna stand around and let you take over.
Spike? That little runt? He doesn't scare me. I've got a surprise for him.
Jake!
I've always wanted to go up against you. Now here's my chance. I'm gonna have a great time destroying you and showing you who's the real hero.
The real hero.
What's wrong with you? Do you realize what you're saying? Do you know who you're talking to? Snap out of it! Pull yourself together! Can you hear me?
It's no use. Somehow he's been brainwashed and
she tried it.
Controlled by Spectre.
That's right, Professor. You're very perceptive. The boy you see here isn't the same anymore. He works for me now. I'm in control, and no one can stop me, especially not you. Well, I've got to go now, but I'm sure we'll be talking again soon.
$14 total. Well, actually, yeah, I mean, obviously there's gonna be a lot of backtracking in this game for 100%. Which is why I'm like, I can't remember if it's required or not.
I'm going for it.
Oh yeah, right, we need to assign the radar. Let's do... Yeah. That's about how I did it on my previous playthroughs. Or just in any Ape Escape game, I usually set radar to triangle. Oh! No. Oh, I'm sorry. They do it with the preview camera. There are limits to the monkey camera. If monkeys too far away, you may not be able to watch them. Oh, we're close to 100 mark though. Oh yeah, the ones that have just Uzis. Wait, what? There you go. Well, I get the feeling there's another one. Let's go back for a second. Okay, there's no more in this area then. Hmm. Alphonse dreams of being Spectre. There we go. Okay. So on the other side of that valley, you need to find Gadget to get over the valley. You don't have something like that. Just make one for you. Yeah, you should. Yeah. So you couldn't get a tutorial. I have a lot of games like that that I just, like, I've owned for years and years. Like, I mean, back when I was a kid. And I just barely touched because I was too stupid to get through, like, the intro segment. Like, an embarrassing amount. The main trilogy, at least, is fantastic. Absolutely play those. Thankfully, they've become pretty easy to emulate. Especially one, because, I mean, Duck Station exists. And, yeah, you can go ahead and buy it if you have a PS4 or a PS5. But you can also simulate it. Sony doesn't really care that much, just go ahead and emulate it. Can't remember if I need a flying gadget for this bit. Or if I need to leave and have him, kind of scare him back in. Hey, you, yeah, let me leave and come back. Also, the PS4 has Ape Escape 2, which, it's a fine version. What it is, though, is that it's the European one, probably because the US one got published by Ubisoft, and there's probably, like, voice actors, just different rights stuff going around. Casey at least 2 times. Make that 3. Just keep pestering her to do it. She'll eventually cave, trust me. No, not like the hard games to stream. Oh, hold on, is there a mailbox somewhere here? I guess I'm not. Played Mortal Kombat Armageddon at the age of 5. Oh, I'm so sorry. It could have at least have been Deception. At least you could have played a good Mortal Kombat. Okay, I can't say that. I prefer Armageddon over than modern MKs. Actually, 9's cool. I just don't like 10 and 11. They're too slow. I'm wondering if I just need to come back here with a slingshot. But like, I don't know, that doesn't seem right. I feel like I can knock him out of the air with just a baton, and I'm just fucking it up. Yu-Gi-Oh! Duels of the Roses is a game I definitely want to stream at some point, because that game is fascinating. Like, it's definitely one of my favorite Yu-Gi-Oh! Games, at least non-traditional. Traditionally, I think the GBA ones are fantastic, like, can't remember the first one's name, but, Worldwide Edition of 2003. Oh yeah, Joe, I'll come back here later. It was second in the series. Wait, what was the first? At least you're talking about Duelist of Roses. Because if there's another one like that, then holy shit, I want to check it out. Or let me guess, it's going to be Japan only, isn't it? To bring me back over to the UFO area, which, hold on. I'm wondering. Yeah. No! No, you son of a bitch! Oh, Forbidden Memories. Okay, the PS1 game then. The really fucking hard one. Yeah, I agree. I definitely want more Yu-Gi-Oh! Games, but in general, honestly, because I mean, like, the amount of Yu-Gi-Oh! Games has tanked in the and with every success, every like iterative generation, like, just kept going more and more down. And it's like, in a sense, I kind of get it, but hmm. Look at his arms. Look at him go. Can be the same one. Monkeys can't be caught without certain gadgets. His way for new gadget come back later. Okay. Oh, a red chimera. Can't wait, candle success. Yeah, have you seen the Silent Hill 2 merch lineup they just put out? It's the experience. I'm just trying to jump on this boat. There we go. Oh no. Oh. Got him. Wow, we still have... Oh no, I'm sorry, we have two left. Where? I know the other one is over there. I can't get to him because he's too high up. I need the flying gadget. Lazy little guy. Dillweed! Get one chance in life. Be named fucking Dillweed. That's it. It's fucking Jover after that. Oh, no. Oh, okay. I need to find... after this level, I'll post this shirt that really made me fucking laugh with regards to the Silent Hill 2 merch. Oh my god, I'm terrible at controlling the rowboat. I have to concentrate my mind on trying to control this. Oh my god. Okay, do you what? Whatever. I'm hopping out. Here's Dillweed. Alright. Let's keep going. Wait, is there a window I can... Oh, where is it? I see that's glowing. I'm just having a bit of a fucking brain dummy moment. Or do I need to whack something? Oh, duh. I completely missed the wheel. Hey, Fufu Buns, thank you for the resub. I definitely need to adjust the, definitely need to readjust the volume for the sound effects, but whatever, we'll just roll with it. No, no. No, no, I got trapped with the rock geometry. There we go, pro gamer. Dillweed acquired. Let's keep going. Oh, Spectre coin. I wonder if I can clip through the geometry and get it, because it's like, it's poking out. Hold on, let me try it. Uh-oh, I don't think I have enough height, momentum in my jump. Okay, no I can't, the game prevents me from doing that, whatever. Getting out of sync on this. Alright, do it. Fuck it, we ball. Fuck it, we ball. Got him.
Yes.
I didn't get the other Spectre coin, but whatever. I'll probably revisit this level.
You did great.
I'm gonna grab a drink real quick. Dark Ruins. He's going for it. Yes! It counted! I didn't think it would work. See levels by using the monkey radar. Oh yeah, they have little RPG stats. Am I able to grab onto this? There we go. Oh yeah, we saw that already. When there's a block inside a room you can push out of your way, try pushing that block. The block looks out of place. Going here. I figured out the monkey's lights. Blue means all is well. Yellow means it's on guard. Red means it's in a panic. Monkey's only shoot lamps from red. When it's red, be careful because the monkey may be violent. Yeah. There we go, we got another shirt. I still have no clue why the why shirts are the life system in this game. Spike just can't fight without that red shirt. Spike is morally required, morally obligated to be dripped up in order to fight the escaped apes. I'm still trying to remember what the what you have to do with the any walls or like surfaces that glow, or if that requires another gadget I need to go back with. I don't know, because I tried whacking him with the saber, it didn't work. Either that or just fucked it up. Hi-ya. What the fuck? Yeah, I can't get him yet. Out fucking skilled. There you go. Okay, I was getting a little nervous there. Oh, is he above me? Yes, okay. No, no. Okay, at least I don't get set back too far. Let me try that again. Magic of analog sticks. Look what they can accomplish. There we go. Holy shit! Nope! Not this time! No, no! Yeah, no shit! There we go. Yeah. Oh, good night, Sizemark Truck. Thank you for joining in. Let me make sure to save. Just in case. Because for all I know, this emulator will just crash. Alright, 10% of the way through. Nice. And what? Just in case. Okay. Hi-ya!
Look what I've got, a new gadget.
Please tell me it's a flying one.
Here's the slingback shooter.
Slingshot, okay. Shoot.
I'm sending the new gadget over to you right now. Try it out in the training room.
I'm going for it.
Yeah, I didn't have to read it. Normal flash and guided. When you have a swing by shooter, you can change balls by pushing a right stick in. I mean, you can also just press X. At least that's what I did. There we go. Hands up. I thought someone was above me. Oh, that's probably what I was saying. Let's see if I can hit it from here. Yeah! Pro gaming. Mr. Enter used a new gadget cutscene. I've never actually seen any of Mr. Enter's videos. That being said, that fact doesn't necessarily surprise me. To an extent, at least. Oh, okay, he's above me. Wondering, No, no, no. Okay, there we go. I was afraid I would move. I'll be moving too slow. I'm seeing the pressure meant by never before seen beasts. I'm curious, for anyone here, what do you think of the PS1's 3D with how, like that kind of, like, wobble effect that the textures seem to have? Because I noticed that, like, people are kind of split on that. Like, so, like, for example, DuckStation has a feature that just outright removes it. Like, it just corrects it so you can, like, everything just looks smooth. Personally, I don't mind it too much, though. I mean, like, I get why people want to get rid of it. Honestly, I'm a sucker for the Saturn's 3D, despite it being pretty bad compared to the PS1s. Oh no, it's just charming to me. It's all about them quads. Tries as a way to pass one quads. Oh shit. Yeah, you'd be surprised. There are a number of people who are like I'm probably not like super bothered about it, but it's like just annoyed enough that they're like, it's like the N64 is better because of this. Which, like, I get it, but I think it's a little extreme. I saw something down there. Oh, it's just seeing things, okay. Oh, it's just telling me about the camera. Okay. Now let's see. Are we able to... No, it... Oh, it just goes through. Keep trying to play like that. I have an ability of three when I very much don't. What if I could knock him down? Let's see. Nah, he just kind of sits there. Resident Monkey Bullier. Oh wait, no, there's cracks there. Hold on. When I was a kid, yeah, I was one of the better ones in that game, at least from my memory of it. King of the Apes. Oh boy. All right. Okay, I still got one up there. I can win this battle of attrition. Never mind. I can't. Okay, hold on. I could have sworn that you were able to just shoot that glow, like any glowing walls, with the with one of the pellets. Oh. Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, hey, Solens.
You did great.
The rival battle.
I've been waiting for this for a long time. This is just between you
and
me.
2 a.m. Oh, yeah.
Follow me.
Yeah, damn. I mean, obviously, don't be afraid to get some sleep if you need it. Oh, wait. No, no. I want to retry.
I'm going for it.
He's going for it. Oh shit, he has way too much on me. Hold on. Oh shit, can I make that back? I don't think I can. Never mind, I can. Oh, no, 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 no! I'll retry. God damn it, I was that close.
I'm going for it.
Oh, no, no, no. Oh, see, I was wondering the same thing. It's like, I'm able to out-lap him just in terms of running, but when jumping, he just fucking leap like he's... I don't know. I had a comparison, I lost it. Did it.
Yes.
Oh shit, I actually skipped the squad. I didn't think he had a voice line. Probably saying like, I'll get you next time. Save again. Dimension X. That's raw. Yeah, how's everyone doing? I'm personally doing pretty good. Don't know how long I'll be streaming. I have something going on at around 10. I'm not sure if I'll end earlier than that or around then, but... I'm sorry, at around like 10:30 or so, but still. I'll just go for a little bit longer. playing Space Euro Jank Overlord. Wait, I think you mentioned this before. Which game was it again that you were playing? I remember you mentioning this during the Ghost Trek stream, I think.
This is the Super Hoop. It protects you and makes you run faster. I'm sending the new gadget over
the
to you.
The Super
right
Hoop.
Now. Try it out in the training room. Without training,
X4. Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah.
Well, good luck and be careful.
I remember, yeah, because it's in one of those genres where I would be kind of interested, but my brain would also be too small. Stepping to switch to open the gate. Reading like a nerd. Well, what have you been reading? You can recall the guides to go to the select button. It's easier that way. Oh wait, yeah, okay, so we have to do it in level. Red Dune and Dune Messiah. I want to get into Dune, but I want to read them first.
You'll find that most of the planet is covered with water. The water net will be very useful in catching the apes. There are lots of dangerous creatures below the surface. Be careful.
Because I want to watch both of the Dune movies, both the Lynch and the newest one, but I want to read the books first, or at least the first like two or three. I can't remember the consensus on like if the whole series is worth reading or it's like stick to the original trilogy. I'm not well versed. All I know is that the original is pretty fucking good. SpongeBoy Meebob. I overdosed on ketamine, and now I'm going to die. I can't do the Mr. Krabs voice. Oh shit, he's right there! Frank Herbert's son are terrible. I can believe that. Like that sounds like a believable premise.
Yeah.
Okay. No. Oh, okay, it's not lethal. They're mainly catching the success of Star Wars prequels. Oh, that makes a lot more sense. Like, that just kind of explains it all. Down, but at least that'll give me another shot at getting across that gap. Or just fuck it up again. Oh, I can just climb the girder. Because I think Star Wars took a lot of inspiration from Dune. Wait, did Virtual Dune came before Star Wars? That actually does sound correct. I just can't say for certain. I don't know.
You did great.
Because what? New Hope was 77, right? Oh, right, and the first Dune movie was in the 80s. So actually, okay, that does start to line up a little bit. Hold on, I need to check this. ...1965, okay, wow, it's way older than I thought it was. I was under the impression it was like, late 70s at earliest, okay, more you know. Am I able to just nuke them? Yes. Okay. Ow. Those sharks still aren't as scary as the eels from Mario 64. I'm not gonna see myself using the ring much in this level, so let me sets. That and that. Okay. I don't think I'm getting that high. Alright, we can't go under. What the fuck is this video game as video game? It's Ape Escape! We have to catch the escaped apes! Also, hello, Casey. Colored monkey's pants show their abilities. Monkey yellow pants are common, normal. Oh, okay. You're just not gonna delve further. Oh, of course. Right when I said I wouldn't have to use the... Okay, fine. Probably could have done it without, but... There we go. Sends fortress. You can't just point at swinging axes and say that sends fortress. That's not how it works. Kinda is, but shut up. Resident Evil 4. You might be on something. Looks like kind of fake video game you see someone playing a TV show. I don't know about that one. Honest, alright. Oop. Is he a suit? Oh, yeah, those post. Yeah, it's, I'm using the PS5 emulator for it, and there's a, what's modern? Does it smooth everything? Not really, but I still don't like the way that looks, so I'm gonna set it back. What's the difference between it, modern, and... I don't know. I'm setting it back to scan lines. Wait, there's still another monkey over here? Oh no, I think that was just the default. Okay, whoops. Uh, I'm unescaping the apes. Jesus Christ, my... can't fucking speak. I go around just catching this the escaped apes. APRA. I don't know. Knuckles levels, but good. Hey, S Group. Owie. Hold on. I got this. Oh, God damn it. Oh, it's... Oh! Do I punch you into MGS3? Oh, good point. I forgot about Snake versus Monkey and its role in the critical role in the series lore. I might. I would just need to get a hold. Actually, I just download it to my hard drive. I'll grab the official original. I forget if it's Subsistence that I need to get specifically, or if it's within Snake Eater itself. I'm pretty sure it's Subsistence. Because yeah, at the moment I only have HD Collection on hand, which does not have the minigame, so I would need to get the PS2 version and probably play through that, which I wouldn't mind. I mean, MGS3 is a fucking good game. Like collecting Doritos, they're funny hit point things. But yo, they're the extra life currency. What's the deal with this? Monkey Ripens are strong attackers, be careful. Okay. Wait, why did I do that? Could have walked across and... Shit. Wait, can I whack it again? Will that raise it? Or can I climb it? Hold on. I'm guessing you're supposed to climb it. Okay, good. I was right. Oh. PS1 3D moment. Ah, shit. I got schmixed. Ape got hands. Oh god. Bites. I need to use the play dead thing more. I think that's what I'm missing. It'll work. Never mind, it won't. I need to. On how it's under night, it was fun. I'm still a little rusty at that game. Really need to flex my two brain wrinkles to get through this one. And also, Joel actually should probably just grind for that extra life. I have just one little Dorito I need to get. So just clear out those two immediately. Ah, I got too close. Yes. Okay, good. Oh, but yeah, Undernight I'm still a little rusty with, but I was able to kind of get the funny Akatsuki tech.
You did
Oh, hold on. Oh god, it was being funny again. I need to resync it real quick. Why am I capturing the apes? Because they've escaped. And also they all have helmets and they're going back in time and rewriting history. Dexter's Island? What, a fucking laboratory wasn't enough? Can't believe this bastard. Please. Alright, what's the deal with this? We found a completely unknown creature, Dexter. I'm pretty sure it's just a dinosaur. Well, actually, or no, I think it's more just a traditional lizard. I gotta assume part of the level will be... Or not, okay. Do you know what? I'll take that as a pleasant surprise. No, we're not playing it's not a war level! Good night, Solons. Discord server? I don't know. I know you're joking with that. I'm gonna open a stream. I might open a server at some point, but I'm lazy. There's a current. Keep me away from there. Oh, unless it's only when he's alerted. Oh no, it is a four level! No! John Escape. His name is Spike. I don't know if his last name could be Escape for all I know. I don't know why, but could be. I mean, yeah, he's built different. Mars digs reggae music. Oh, he's inside. Weird. Okay, so... the flesh cube. Come on, come on, I just want to get... Okay, good. Oh, I'm gonna lose a life, aren't I?
This bites.
Oh wait, I can do the stomp, right. Or not. Okay. Here I was thinking I was so clever. Okay, you get, it's like little entryways. Camera, please. Camera, please. Please! Yeah. I thought I was able to slip through the... I guess not? Because I'm... Oh, no. Another aggressive one. Yes! Oh, I gotta try that again and see what's up. Yeah, I could have sworn you were able to just crawl through here, but I guess not. Yeah, it wasn't gonna work. I don't have any reggae music I can play without fucking flagging DMCA. Hey, blue footed newt. I'm enjoying it. Thank you for the compliment. We're catching the escaped apes. I can't think of any more alliterative alternatives to it. Aside from the Austrian title Skedaddled Simians. Gonzo gorillas. Overt. It kind of works. Gonzo gorillas is really good though. Complicated maze in Dexter's body. Don't get lost. I'll try not to. Oh shit. What the hell is that? Ew. How kind of miss all of those. There we go. Oh, I wonder. I think that was a tapeworm. Average Super Metroid boss. Fucking Spore Spawn 2 Gore Edition. Oh, it worked! I don't know how that worked, but that worked! Damn, they want a lot out of me this level. It technically wasn't, but it was probably just the PS1's 3D freaking out, like, in terms of how it, you know, layer rendering. So chances are I did make it, and just, like, it just didn't look it. Oh god, that's a lot of those. I got an idea, at least. Oh, I see. It's one of those. I should have collected the extra life sitting there before I left. I forgot I had only one monkey left. I'll probably do one more level. Round it out in a nice 2.5 hours.
You did great.
This implies I'm gonna get the next level done in 10 minutes or less. I might. What era of history did that just take place in? For that level, good question. I actually don't know. Oh, there you go. I don't think there's an exact year, but there's your reference point at least. New Freezeland. snowy mammoth.
You're heading towards the Ice Age. It will be extremely cold in this next area. The planet is covered with ice, and in some areas with strong winds, the temperatures will drop below freezing. The apes have adapted well to their new surroundings. Take full advantage of the gadgets so you can quickly move on.
Dexter's weird, fucked up. Oh, no, don't call it that.
Let's go!
You'll be hurt if you fall in. Oh boy.
Hi-ya!
Yeah, I saw the face. I just mean, like, I know what you mean. Just, God. Why'd you call it that? Should probably switch this back over to the radar. Ice, suffer some brain freeze. Keep trying to. There we go. Oh, there we go. It's Pumpkin Hill Zone. I mean, was there a point in time where the pumpkins took over? No, don't say Halloween, it doesn't count. Sleepy Hollow. Oh, it's just a reminder about the sea. Gotcha. Okay, for some reason I thought it was just ice I could walk on. Whoops.
Point.
You are lost. Use monkey radar to find the monkeys. I was following the radar. No, no, no.
This bites.
Oh, I'm just trying to see if I can launch myself up. I wonder if I can. Oh shit! I wonder if I can do that. Just juke myself up over the area and just skip it. Let me try it. Ate some yellow snow. I see.
Be careful next time.
Damn, I didn't think I'd get a game over. Okay, good, good. It doesn't just go back to the save screen, or else I would be fucking screwed. Hold on, let me just make sure I didn't get good. All right. I will complete this level. I just wanted to save as well, just to be on the safe side. Ape status. It's Jover. Over the hedge. Jowari no Seraph. No, wait, does it retain my... Okay, good. It retains the unescaped apes. Oh, okay. Oh, wait. I'm an idiot. Let's switch to... I thought I was able to use the hoop to go through that. I guess not. Okay. Fuck me, I guess. Why is he running faster up at ice up? Because there actually is an item specifically made for going past certain objects. So it actually, I was thinking that I could use that item to then go up the ledge. I was onto something. Those are damage. Ah, shit. Gotcha. Damn, that's aggressive. If you break your door, your console fucking explodes. Dude, half of the Melee professional community would just be out an entire console and copy of Melee. It would be an epidemic. Alright. I think I'll leave things off here. Cause we actually made some good progress. I mean, like, consider I might even gunning for 100%, and I'm on backtrack at the moment. We're at 23% completion, and I think... I want to say this might be a two-setting playthrough. I'll decide if I'll go back and do 100%, because it's not that hard. I mean, and plus, it'll at least be good. Just kind of put content out there. Or I might just hop over to Ape Escape 2. Wait, what? Oh, you mean for the Melee comment? Oh no, I was saying, like, do you know the amount of professional Melee players that get heated and tossed their GameCube controllers? It's hilariously high. If at World Pama Purin raised where it's just like throwing the console just causes the GameCube to explode. Imagine going up to a tournament setup. Just losing a stock, tossing your controller, and the entire setup just nukes. Alright. Okay. We'll leave things off there. Oh, let me also save in the save state just in case. There we go. But yeah, thank you everyone who came by. I'll probably stream on Monday. I'll make sure, because I have stuff to do tomorrow, so I won't be streaming then. But, yeah, thank you everyone for coming by, and I hope you have a good night.